In this video, we're going to talk about some new information about the potential upcoming March snowstorm. Also, we got to talk about the medium range forecast, which is showing multiple signals for big severe weather outbreaks as we go deeper into March. Welcome back, y'all. Ryan Hall here with the weather forecast. I'm sorry I didn't upload yesterday. I was actually out covering a pretty significant flooding event here in Kentucky. Remember, sometimes if I'm out storm chasing, I won't be able to upload every single day. However, you can keep up with everything I'm doing out in the field by following my Facebook page and my Twitter page. The links for all my accounts are in the description down below. Now, without further ado, let's start talking about the weather. All right, here's a big old look at the United States of America, and we have quieted down a little bit once again. Our only area of significant precipitation is going to be down here in Alabama, moving into Georgia. We've got some heavy rain moving across Interstate 85 in Alabama. That's going to be moving into Georgia, the LaGrange area, Columbus, Atlanta. You guys are going to be seeing some heavy rain showers around the time that this video goes up, so be on the lookout for that. Thankfully, this area of precipitation is staying south of Tennessee and Kentucky and the Ohio River Valley down here because, man, this place, we were absolutely inundated by flooding over the past couple days. In fact, there are some rivers in Kentucky that will reach a crest that has never been seen before in recorded history. Also, look up here in the Northeast. We've got wind chill advisories and high wind warnings up here in Maine, New Hampshire, Massachusetts, and Connecticut. Like I was telling you guys for like a whole week, the Arctic air is coming. Some of you didn't believe me, but here it is. Winds over 30 miles an hour may cause wind chills as low as negative 35 degrees in these areas. Woo! Ooh, that's cold. All right, let's look at the future on the weather models. All right, here's the Euro model. Remember, as I start talking about the future, you can keep up with the date and time up here. It'll be constantly displayed, okay? Okay, so here we are around the time this video goes up. We've got our rain showers down here in Mississippi, Alabama, and Georgia. Once again, that's going to be moving off to the northeast pretty quickly. And here's our cold air up in Maine here. Once again, with those gusty winds, as you can see, those isobars really close together. If you live up there, bundle up. Those wind chills are going to hurt. And then as I play this forward a little bit, this is really interesting. We got a little clipper that comes down through here. Tomorrow, that's going to bring some flurries to New York, Vermont, New Hampshire. Nothing crazy. This little system's going to be out of here tomorrow. And then look at this. On Thursday, we're going to be really quiet across the United States. Like, literally, everybody's going to have pretty nice weather. I mean, it is going to be cold up here in the Northeast. And we are talking about possibly some moderate rain showers down here in the Southwest. Oddly, here we are. Everybody's having quiet weather except for LA. Really? That's interesting. But yeah, we do have that little disturbance coming on shore there. But for the most part, tomorrow will be one of the better weather days in the United States of America than we have seen in a while. Nobody's experiencing any major storms. But as I push this forward, things do start to change. We're starting to see some heavy snow break out in the Four Corners, especially in the higher elevations on March 4th at 7 a.m. Let's push that forward. What happens with it? You got a low pressure system, an upper level low, kind of hanging out around the panhandles of Texas and Oklahoma here, bringing some rain to Oklahoma and Kansas. And once again, those snow showers on the backside in Colorado. What happens with that? It does try to move south into the Gulf of Mexico. And look, this is March 6th. This is the one, okay? This is the snowstorm that we talked about in the past video and that everybody's kind of like watching and iffy about. This is what I believe is our last shot at a major significant snowstorm for the East Coast. Now, don't get me wrong. We may get some skiffs of snow, some 2 to 4, 3 to 6 inches here and there, all the way through April. It's possible. But this little system right here, based on everything I'm seeing with the North Atlantic Oscillation, with the upcoming pattern after this gets through, this looks like it might be our last chance at a blockbuster winter storm on the East Coast. I'm talking about like a widespread foot or more situation. And the odds of this becoming that storm is still just as unlikely as it was when I posted my last video. But the fact of the matter is that signal is still there. It's still showing up. And this is how the deterministic model of the Euro shows it. Here we are on Saturday, March 6th at 10 a.m. We've got our storm in the Gulf of Mexico. It's going to transfer its energy across Florida into the Atlantic Ocean. We do get some interaction with our cold air up here, but the Euro shows this storm is out to sea. Look, we do have the cold air in place. We do have a storm down here, and we do have a trough, but there is no blizzard for the East Coast, according to the 0Z run of the Euro. Now, look at this. The 12Z run had this storm a lot further north and west, and it also had it a little bit stronger. So that's kind of what's happening with this storm. It's waffling back and forth between being a coastal storm and an out-to-sea storm. Wherever this ends up, it will be a significant storm, and it will cut to the north and east. However, it's going to be a much more significant storm and possibly a major snowstorm for the East Coast if this happens closer to the coast and starts getting organized down here near the Carolinas. The GFS shows a very similar solution here. This is the 12Z run of the GFS, so this is brand new data. And then the Canadian also shows an out-to-sea storm there. So as of right now, none of our deterministic models are showing a significant East Coast storm here. But you're like, Ryan, why the heck are you leading us on then? Why are you still talking about it if there's no chance? There is a chance, okay? But it is small. And that's the kind of stuff I like to talk about on this YouTube channel. If I just talked about how it's going to be sunny in Missouri all week, nobody would watch. Would you be here? But no, for real, there is still a chance that this comes up north and west and becomes a major storm for the East Coast. Now, let me tell you why. Let me tell you why I'm still holding on to that thread. This is the Euro Ensembles, okay? So a group of a bunch of models put together, came together, and agreed on this setup right here, okay? So we've got a big ridge out here. We've got our trough right here. We've got our blocking up here. Like everything, this is like, if you was mixing together the ingredients for a major snowstorm on the East Coast, this is the map you would draw up. Obviously, it would be nice to have this tilted a little bit more, to have this a little bit further west. It would be nice to have this ridge tilted up this way a little bit more and a little bit further west. We are going to have our storm form down here, and how it interacts with this trough is going to depend on how it sets up and how the tilt is as we go forward. So the upper air dynamics for a major storm are still there, and it's not just the Euro. Check this out. The GFS shows it, and even the Canadian shows it, okay? So the opportunity is still there for a major winter storm. We'll know a lot more about this tomorrow, so make sure you watch that video. Okay, so let's complete our medium range forecast here. We're going to get this storm out of here no matter what. It is going to bring down some more cold air here. We're going to see some cooler temperatures reach all the way as far south as Savannah, Georgia with this system on Sunday, March 7th. Let's keep pushing this forward, though. Let's see what else we've got going on out there. Once again, after that goes by, we're going to enter a period of quietness. March 9th, here we go. This is my birthday, by the way. March 9th, it looks like I'm going to be enjoying some nice weather with high pressure in place. We do have a storm system coming together over here in the Rockies. Look here, Idaho, Montana, Nevada, California, Oregon, Washington. They're all dealing with rain and snow as another Pacific system comes in. Let's see what else happens with that as we push it forward. That turns into a major storm for Wyoming and Colorado. Probably going to be talking about some big time snow totals with that. But then we get a low pressure system that organizes in northern Nebraska here. And this is a classic spring look for severe thunderstorms. Watch this. It winds up, turns into a 981 millibar low pressure system. And then on 7 a.m. on March, we've got a possible cold front moving out here that would in fact probably cause a widespread severe weather outbreak for the traditional Tornado Alley areas, and then eventually into the Dixie Alley and Ohio Valley regions as we move forward. Look at that. That is a severe weather signature if I have ever seen one. So looking a little bit further on the GFS, it sees that same storm too, and we've actually got some heavy snow back here on the backside in North Dakota and Montana. Once again, we do have that tail coming down with possibly some significant severe weather going on in Missouri, Illinois, moving into the Ohio Valley there. Look at here, March 11th. This could be one of our first widespread severe weather outbreaks down here in the southeast. And then that's not it. Look, we've got another storm system following almost the same path with heavy snow in South Dakota and North Dakota and Minnesota with that tail. Once again, with probably some significant severe weather down here, we've got a short wave moving through. And on March 14th, we have another possibly line of strong and severe thunderstorms moving through into the Ohio Valley. And that is very interesting. And then what's going to happen after that? Bada bing, bada boom, boom. There it is. Another storm that's possibly going to be a major winter storm on the northern side here in Minnesota from Duluth all the way back into North and South Dakota there. And then a sharp cold front out in front of it. This is showing enough cold air behind it there to maybe charge up some snow showers for Chicago and Michigan and into Ohio, Kentucky, West Virginia, Pennsylvania there. Look at that last frame with that secondary low pressure system forming up here. That actually could end up being a major winter storm for the Northeast, but that's 384 hours out. The placement of snow, the placement of these low pressure systems in the cold air, that's not what we're looking at here, okay? It's way too far out to be forecasting with a deterministic run of the GFS. What we're really looking at here is the fact that we have three storms coming in from the Pacific that are taking a similar path, okay? So this right here is going to be the road for storms to take as we go forward, and it looks to me like there's going to be three of them that have the ability to spark up secondary short waves down here in the Midwest, which will then lead to widespread severe weather activity down here in traditional Tornado Alley, the Ohio Valley, and the Dixie Alley regions as we go into the middle of March. If you live in any of those areas, make sure you're prepared for severe weather outbreaks, because I think March is going to be especially active, especially after we get past March 10th. I think we're going to start seeing those widespread severe weather outbreaks and possibly even tornado outbreaks as we go forward. Just look at all that moisture coming in. Look at this 9th and 10th of March. Man, this is spring coming, guys. Look at that moisture coming into the Midwest and then getting flung off to the east. This is a classic sign of spring, guys, and also a classic sign that we're getting ready to enter a very active period of severe weather for pretty much everybody in this area right here. All right, guys, that's all the weather talk I have for you today. Thank you for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, and turn those notifications on so you never miss a video. Also, check out theweatherhut.com, where we have some super spicy weather merch. Show off how much of a weather weenie you are to your friends with your Snowtown Baby hat, t-shirt, or sticker. And that's all I got for you, so I'll see you again tomorrow. Goodbye.